Laundry. Something we all have to go through on a weekly basis. It's not like we have to do it. You can just let all the clothes pile up on the floor until you have nowhere left. And then walk around your apartment with your wiener hanging out like Magic Mike. I've gotten to this point in life where I wasn't proud of myself. I would literally pile up laundry for weeks until it smells like a hauling garbage truck. You guys know that smell? It's like uncollected city trash. Whenever the boy is going strike, this is the kind of shit you have to deal with. I was so lazy that I would wear a singular underwear twice. Just flip it inside out. Side A and side B, just like a cassette tape. I would let it even pile up like a landfill. It's scary to know what I would be in the next 10 years. But I can say this, I slowly changed after realizing how bad it is to go to work without underwear. Physical labor and having your balls grind up in your inner thighs can build bad rashes. You don't have to tell me how disgusting I could be. I learned my lesson over the past years. Yes, years. And I'm good now. I know laundry can be a baggage when you're busy, but that doesn't mean that you can't have fun doing it. There's a couple of brews in the library that you can select for a good session. The classic old PBR, Ireland's finest, which is Guinness, or the grass is greener on the other side, Sierra Nevada. I think I'll go with Sierra Nevada. It matches perfectly with anything. It's an old-time classic. It's the bread and butter of pale ales, the beginning of time. Can't go wrong with some good beers and dirty laundry. Everybody likes to take it upon themselves when they're having a shitty day, like, I need a beer, I'm stressed out, I'm having a bad day at work, my wife hates it when Super goes live. Well, for me, I gotta deal with a bunch of panties that probably got a bunch of nut stains that can cover up a whole swimming pool. Our laundry facility is quite nice. Sometimes you have panties laying around like a spring break, which is not. It's just a regular Sunday morning. We roughly got about 15 machines that are operated by tap cards. So you gotta slap your card on and load your money like it's a prepaid credit card. Prices per session is roughly about $7 per week. Not bad. I usually spend about $40 a week on brews, so a guy like me can't complain. Since this laundry facility is linked to our building, I could just go back upstairs and come back later. At the meantime, I would rather enjoy a pale ale to the face. I haven't been drinking this much, but when I do, they are a treat. First, I have to say, I love the artwork on the can. A very peaceful scenery of the mountains. It feels like I'm in North Carolina, which I'm not. The color is beautifully amber gold with a decent cloud coverage. Roughly ranging 1 to 2 fingers. There's a bit of sediment in the brew, which is quite hard to see, but when you down the whole thing, you can find bits at the end of the glass. It has a firm, bubbly layer, nothing rocky, a lot of micro bubbles, and is very pleasant. My chemosensory picks up a bit of sweetness with piney notes, very floral. It smells amazing. The tongue gets a slap of sweet, toasty caramel, apple, and citrus. A medium mouthfeel, but does layer out that smoothness with a touch of hops. The finish isn't dry, it's juicy. This has to be one of the best pale ales out there. It's very neutral. You can't hate on it. If you do, you are a terrible person with a bad taste. You might as well go back to yamming on ass if you think that's delicious. If only they had these at the bars, my bill would rake up to $100 per session, and I would gladly tip $20 just for the good vibes. These type of beers are meant to be consumed with ease. It's a slow sipper. It's not a ground and pound type. It would be a waste of money if that were to happen. Also, did I mention? It's a 5.6 percenter, which is great to know. That extra alcohol by volume will give you the swing you need in the morning. Two of these, then you'll be swinging a home run. One per day is good enough for me. The more I drink these, the less I would appreciate them. It's like a psychological thing. You lose the enjoyment by overindulging. It's like being on the same roller coaster ride 20 times to only find out it doesn't satisfy you anymore. Slowly taking in the love is the perfect way. Rushing it can only lead to dirty laundry.